Cody.
This segment of Trojans Live is brought to you by Rock and Riley's USC, the best place to be during the game. We've got Taylor Mays here, always a fan favorite, and we've seen a lot of Taylor during camp. You've been around and moving on sort of the next phase a little bit. You have seen this team a lot. I'm wondering just initially what's your first impressions. I know you were on the sideline for the game on Saturday. What do you think of what you've seen so far?
Yeah, I've been around. I've been excited. It's crazy how fast this time goes, and I get older, but the players stay the same age. But I've been impressed. You know, this team, like Coach Helton said, this team has a lot of potential. I mean, I heard about Mike Pittman.
Yeah.
And then once I saw Tyler Vaughn on Saturday, I was thinking, man, this guy can play. He could play X. He could play Z.
Yeah.
He's really talented. And there's just a lot of weapons across the offense, across the defense. And I think it'll just come down to if these guys can execute and if they can be disciplined and take care of the little things. And that's really what football is about, is executing little things and being disciplined throughout the week.
Taylor, what have you been up to, man? What have you been doing? What's the next phase here? You know you've been playing a long NFL career. What have you kind of been up to?
Well, I still wanted to play, but that's just how.
Hey, Sean, that's enough, man. You can't play anymore,
You know.
Just get old and fat, and that's it, man.
I don't know about all that.
You'll get fat.
You know, the NFL is tough, but I'm just trying to move on and trying to get into the next phase. And I've been hanging around here, like Jordan said, and it's been good. And USC's been very receptive of me and just letting me come out and hang out with everybody. And so I guess we'll see moving forward where it goes. But I'm excited about it, and I can't talk enough about the USC Trojan alumni and that family and what that means. I didn't understand that initially coming out of college, but now the older I get and the more people I meet, it's really been awesome.
And when the guys come and talk to you, and you had sort of an odyssey of a post-college football career, all different stops, interesting things happen in your career, and they come up and ask you, what kinds of things do you tell the current players about what to expect?
So I talked to, I've spoken to several of them, especially the guys in the secondary, and I wanted to be careful not to step on anybody's toes, and I know Coach Burns, and I didn't want to, tell them to do something any different than Coach Burns is telling them, but I was talking to Talanoa, I was talking to Isaiah, and I was just telling them some small things that, these guys are 18 to 22. They're very impressionable. They're young. They need to almost be guided in the right direction. And a lot of them want to be great players. They just don't necessarily know how to do it yet. So I was just trying to tell them some things that I did right, that I know I did right in my college days, and some things that I did wrong, and just really trying to keep them with their heads down, focused on the task at hand, and not get distracted by, things around college life, L.A., just stay focused, and it'll really pay off for you in the end.
Talk about some of the safeties on the team now, man. USC has had quite the illustrious safety position. You got guys like Troy and Ronnie Lott.
Definitely.
And guys like yourself, all Americans who play this position. What does it mean, I think, when you talk about all those guys to play safety at USC and the emotion it brings for you as that kind of comes up?
So that was the reason why I wanted to come to USC, to be a part of a – not just safeties, but football in general. But, you have some of the best safeties that have ever played that have gone to USC. And it's just a tradition that you feel an obligation that you have to stay at a certain standard. And you don't want to be the player that lowers the standard.
Oh, he was no Ronnie Lott.
But they're always going to say, I can live with that, or he's not Troy, I can live with that. But at the same time, that's what makes USC special, and you could look at any position group, and you just have great players everywhere that have gone and played at USC, and you want to just – I always wanted to maintain the same standard that the players ahead before me had set.
Yeah, a lot of the show we've talked about a true freshman quarterback that's going to be thrown into the mix this weekend. Yeah. We saw a true freshman, Drake Jackson, start the opener. I remember your freshman year, you went right out there early on in your career.
Yeah.
What was that experience like? I mean, how difficult is it as a true freshman to go right out there and try to play with grown men?
Well, it's definitely nerve-wracking. You don't really, 6 months before, you're at your senior prom and wearing a rented suit, and then you're playing in front of, a ton of people. But it's just one of those things that if there's a will, there's a way. And when you go to a program like USC, especially when I was here, I had a great supporting cast. My coaches were great. My teammates were great. So I wanted to be a great player and really help the team. And I think I just had a bunch of great teammates around me that really helped me and put me in position to play well.
Do you have a pick in your first start, if memory serves? Is that right?
Did I?
Well, three-time All-American. You better.
No. But here's the funny thing is I didn't really go for interceptions because I always went for the hit because it was safer.
That's my next
question. So that's what I told Isaiah after the game. I said, you're better than me because I wouldn't have caught the ball. I would have just had to hit him. We probably would have got a penalty and we would have lost the game.
Yeah.
Speaking of teammates, you had some great teammates you play with. You keep in touch with guys. I know we talked about Brian Cushing. I know I played with Brian and some quite the characters in your class. You got some characters in your class.
Yeah, we had, I like to say, some very interesting guys. But Brian's still a good friend of mine. He was my roommate for 3 years. And I talked to Thomas Williams right before I came in here, actually. Saw just a couple weekends ago when the team had the scrimmage, saw a bunch of guys. And it's just crazy how fast the time goes. But I don't think these relationships will stay the same for the rest of our lives. We could not talk for 10 years, and right when we talk, it'll pick up right where it left off. And that's what's special about the time that we spent together at USC.
Yeah, my question was, you were known for your big hits, right? That was just sort of your signature thing. And Sean was talking about how the game's changed since he played. The game's changed since you played. It was only a decade ago you were at USC. It's a completely different game, particularly for your position. What do you think of the way the game's changed, and how difficult is it to play safety as physically as a guy like you wanted to?
I would have been out.
I would have been in trouble. Targeting.
Well, I got fined several times in the NFL for helmet.
Right.
And the hard part about college football is they'll suspend you for
a game.
Right. And I've seen that happen.
And eject you.
Yeah, and I feel bad as a defense player. I don't want to hit a defenseless receiver in his helmet, obviously, but I also don't want to hit him in the knee because I feel like that could be just as damaging to his career. So it's just hard, and it's just something that you have to practice repeatedly, trying to lower your strike zone, as the coaches will say, and hit him in the chest. But sometimes when you try to hit him in the chest and he drops down, you accidentally hit him in the face mask. And it just kind of is what it is. I think it's football. It's not basketball or soccer. It's football. We should just let football be football.
All right. Well, football's going to be football on Saturday. It's always a good old-fashioned physical game. USC and Stanford Trojan fans get one free admission to the Ralph's Ultimate Tailgate Experience at select USC football home games this fall when you purchase $35 of participating items at Ralph's. Look for the signs and tags in the store. Every $35 you spend gets you one admission. Taylor Mays, we appreciate you joining us. Maybe we'll get you on later in the season, too. Always like your analysis of what's going on with the Trojans. Next up, we've got a USC captain, Christian Rector, in the house to close out Trojans Live.